greetings, I'm the Count Gordival, and welcome to Creature Feature, the weekly web program. Tonight I'm about... that's a gong. Someone must be at the door. Come in! Come in! Ah! It's none other than Dr. Paul Bear! Hey, it's good to see you! How are you?
How am I doing what?
Never mind. Oh. I knew this was going to be like, Kate Stone, Dr. Paul Bearer, he hosts Tombstone Tales on the CW44 in Tampa. He's a great guy, you know. Hey, you know, it's great to see you. You're here just in time.
Oh.
I'm going to show the movie The Last Woman on Earth.
Oh boy.
You know, but I was thinking, you know, if you had the last woman on Earth, where would you go to look for her, huh? The shoe store, of course.
You know, I kind of would look for her in the kitchen.
Well, you know, there's a problem with that. You know, the guys that think that a woman's place is in the kitchen forget that that's where they keep the knife.
Well, you just lost your audience with that one.
You know, you got a good point there.
Oh, yes, I do.
Say, you know, I've always viewed women as being like roads. The more curves they have, the more dangerous.
Ooh. You know, I've always thought, thinking about that, maybe a sports car driving, never mind. You know, but seriously.
Okay, seriously.
You know, here you are, the last woman on Earth. You've got the whole planet full of guys to choose from. You would think that the last woman on Earth would want to find a guy who's kind, generous, loving, compassionate, a guy who could share his feelings openly with her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, she'd probably find out they all have boyfriends.
Ooh, okay. You know, there must be advantages, though, to being the last woman on Earth. You could be as rotten to the guys as you want, and they still would love you.
Yes, that's true. But you know, being the last woman on Earth, you kind of have to think, eventually she would want a mate. Mm. But how could you tell?
Well, you know, I guess it would really depend on the color of her hair.
Oh, okay,
really,
yeah, do
really.
Tell.
Yeah, well,
do
you know, okay. If she's a blonde, the mating call would be, I'm drunk. If she's a brunette, the mating call would be, is the blonde gone yet?
Okay.
And if she's a redhead, the mating call is, next. Speaking about next, yes. Let's get on with our movie, The Last Woman on Earth, on Creature Feature, the weekly web program with Count Gordival and Dr. Paul Bearer. Go, watch the movie. I'm trying to imagine what the sales pitch was like when the guy who had the idea for this movie went to present it to the studio. Okay, so picture this, okay? We got this huge boardroom, glass all around, the top of a building in Tokyo overlooking the Ginza. Real expensive property, okay? And in comes these guys, and they're wearing, you know, the latest suits, you know, with skinny ties and all this, because this is back then. And they come in, they sit down, they bring out their charts, and they bring out their graphics and all the rest of this stuff, and they try to sell the studio on a movie based on a giant, evil, flying turtle that breathes fire and is propelled through the space at great speed with flaming farts. I would like to have been a fly on the wall on that presentation. Why? Because it got green-lighted and they made the movie. And to see what they did with it, let's watch the first part of Camera of the Invincible and Creature Feature. Flaming farts. Jeez. Yes, this week I bring you an Italian film where everyone plays roles in English. It's a story about a wealthy English lord, Lord Cunningham, okay? Well, he is facing a mental breakdown due to the death of his red-headed wife, Evelyn, who he fears was cheating on him. Now, instead of doing the natural thing that a guy would do, and that is go out and get blind drunk and then go cry on the shoulder of your mistress, no, Lord Cunningham has to go cruising the bars looking for redheads, which he picks up one at a time, brings back to the castle, and seduces. followed by tortures and kills them. Well, this is starting to create a problem. So his good friend, the English doctor, also played by an Italian actor, says, hey, look, you can't keep doing this. You got a problem here. We're going to solve your mental illness by having you take one of these redheads and marry her. And marriage will solve all your problems. I don't think I've ever heard anyone say that before, but that's okay. Anyway, it also solves another problem. It prevents redheads from becoming extinct in the village. All right, so I'll tell you what we're going to do. If this sounds a little bit like Downton Abbey, made by a bunch of Italians with a redheaded fetish and a thing for horror, you wouldn't be very far away. So let's go watch the night Evelyn came out of the grave. You had to think about that. The night Evelyn came out of the grave. Big title on Creature Feature, the Weekly Med program. It's time I did my own music video for the 21st century, but I couldn't use a song from the 80s. I had to do something more contemporary. And I thought, and I thought, and I thought. And I said, you know, back in the 70s, I became the self-proclaimed sex symbol of Washington, and I haven't heard that anyone has taken my place. So I listened to contemporary music, and I decided that it was time to do a music video based on a song by LMFAO. Are you ready? Hit it!
When I walk on by, girls be looking like Debbie Fly. I pimp to the beat, walking down the street in my new the freak, yeah. This is how I roll, animal print pants out of control. It's Red Bull with the big leg roll, and like Bruce Lee, I got the clout, yeah.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out. When I walk in the spot, this is what I see. Everybody stops and is staring at me. I got passion in my pants and I ain't afraid to show it, show it, show it, show it.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Aye.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Check it out. Check it out.
You like it? It's yours.